So I think Professor Solanki explained everything about this bulk creep combination. We are till the diffusion. So I hope you can put the diffusion values here, like what is would be the peak doping concentration. And suppose you want 300 nanometer junction and the sheet resistance of around say 70 or 50 ohms per square. So you can check these values to get, I mean you can modify these values to get that kind of sheet resistance and junction depth. The other way around is that you know the peak depth, peak doping concentration, and you want to achieve a certain junction depth, then you can put these values to get to see what is the sheet resistance with this, those values. So you can play with these two parameters to find out what would be the sheet resistance and junction depth of the after the diffusion. And the diffusion type is n type, since this is the front diffusion, first front diffusion we are saying, and the diffusion profile you can select from here. So uniform for kind of plasma and implantation, and Gaussian and Heron function for the thermal diffusion. Okay. And as Professor Solanki mentioned, we can also define the back surface field by going to the rear diffusion. So here you can enable it and put it the same way. Only thing is that you will achieve some higher value of the junction depth. Here it is mentioning around 2.75 micrometer. So you can adjust these values again to get that kind of back surface field. Only thing is that here you have to put the thing as FP type, because it is P plus back surface field. So it is at the back side. So we will put the P type thing. Okay. So right now I am removing this part. Okay. Now the bulk recombination. If you double click on it, you will get the tau value at the bulk. That means the lifetime you can specify in terms of microsecond. You will find the net LLI tau. You can specify just these values like 100 microseconds, and you can see what is the diffusion length as well as the you can see the diffusion length. And this LLI means low level injection, okay, low level injection, because this lifetime is also dependent on the injection level. So at low level injection, this is the value. So you can specify the front surface recombination velocity. Okay, again at low level injection you can put say, let's say 1000. Okay, this is the surface recombination velocity to specify at the front surface how much recombination is happening. Okay, and you can see the saturation current density here. Similarly, you can put the rear surface velocity. So again, let us put it 1000. This is just some number I am taking. Okay, so by these three combination you can put the material quality and the surface quality. So first is bulk recombination, that is mentioned in terms of the lifetime of the carrier. Second is the front surface recombination velocity, that is in terms of the SRV, and the back surface recombination velocity. Okay. Now after selecting all these device parameters, now comes the point where we put the excitation thing. So what kind of excitation we are giving? We are giving the Wonson AM 1.5 global. So the solar spectrum is called the AM 1.5 global spectrum. So that radiation is falling on the surface of the solar cell. Okay. So to select that, first you will not find this thing here. So you go to the excitation on the top menu. Okay. So here you will find an option open. If you click open, you will find two kind of excitation given. One is Wonson excitation, the other one is the Solanki. So the Wonson excitation is used for the normal IV measurement of the IV characteristics. Okay, how the cell is operating in practice under the sun. And the Solanki is for the measuring the quantum efficiency of the cell. See, the basic difference between these two is that it is a basically a white light composing of all the wavelengths of different intensity. So it has a certain spectrum. And this Solanki is a excitation file that contains all the wavelengths, but they are irradiated over the cell separately. So when I select Wonson, it will give all the wavelength together, and the Solanki will give all the wavelengths separately. Okay. So for primary reason, I am selecting one sun for to study the IV characteristics. So if I open it, it will automatically select all these things. So here you can see the spectrum is also selected as 1.5G.SPCs. If you double click on it, you will find a file selected from the external point. So if you select the excitation from onesun.exe, it will automatically select all these things. So you don't need to mention separately. Okay. But here you can see other kind of excitation too, M0 for extraterrestrial application, M1.5D only direct radiation for concentrated kind of solar cell, and M1.5G. Okay. So excitation file is selected. Now the whole thing is set. Now you can just run the thing and see the effect. So if you just go for run, it will display the results at the bottom. Okay, what is the open circuit voltage? It is around 625 millivolts. What is the short circuit current? It is 3.248 ampere. And what will be the peak power? So from these three values, you can calculate a fill factor as well as efficiency. Okay. Now let us look at the graphs. If you go the graphs, you will show some primary graphs out here. So the first one is this one is the IV characteristics of the solar cell in the negative direction. The current is in this direction, in the negative direction. Okay. The red one is the IV one. And the green one is the power versus voltage. Okay. You can just select some portion of the cell to see what is happening exactly out there, like how exact is for the greater thing. Okay. Other than these IV characteristics, you can go for different options like energy bands and generation and decombination. Distance like that. So all these things are available in the graph section, and you will have in spatial section all the things like what is the doping density. This is for the p-type solar cell. I mean p-type substrate. Okay. If you want to see the junction profile. Okay. So if you select the doping density, it is just showing the green one, right? So that is the base doping density, but actually there is another red one on the sideline here. If you just focus here, you will find another doping concentration thing happening here. Can you find it? So this is a portion. So this is the profile of the n-type thing, the carrier n-type dopant atoms, and this is the for the p-type dopant atoms. So this is the junction. So you can see what is the junction depth. It is around 320 or something like that. Okay. And the concentration, as we said, the concentration we have already defined as 1e^20 peak concentration at the surface. So this is the diffusion profile. Okay. And other than that, you can also see other things like carrier densities, electrostatic potential, all these things you can see. Now if you go for temporal thing, it will find that quantum efficiency at the lowest part, but it is not showing here, not able, it is disabled because we have selected one sun excitation. So it is not showing. If you want to measure, if you want to see the quantum efficiency, let us go back to the parameter menu. So you click on this point, you will get back to the parameter thing. You just select scanq as the excitation file. Okay. Now again run the simulation. And now go back to the thing, you will find the EQV and IQV and the reflectance. So this is the EQV, this is IQV, and this is the reflectance. Alright. So first you go back to this thing, parameter page, select excitation file as scanqv. Scan QA and just run the simulation once again. Now go back to this graph thing and you will find the IQV, UQV and wavelength, reflectance against wavelength. Okay. I think in the simulator they are just subtracting this IQV from the 100% level. So this is just the subtraction only here. If you want to save the data of this graph, just right click on it. Sorry, not right click, go to graph, go to particular graph, go to this graph, you will get the copy graph data. See, there are four, two different graph options. One is four curve and the other one is single. So, there are four graphs here. If you click on particular graph, it will show, and then you go to this graph option, you will find copy graph data. You copy it, go to notepad file or something else, let us say notepad, and just paste it. You will get all the data out here. Okay. Okay. You go to a particular graph, go to this graph option at the menu, you will see the copy graph data. You copy it and open a notepad file and just paste it there. Sorry? No, three are there. The first one is source wavelength, this one. Next is the internal quantum efficiency. Next is external quantum efficiency. And the last one is primary surface. Now, if you want to add, okay, let me see. Suppose you have only two graphs and you want to add one more thing, just click on this axis, you will get the user defined graph thing. See, so here you have the x axis as primary source wavelength or lambda, then curve 1 is internal IQV, curve 2 is external IQV, sorry, EQV, and curve 3 is primary surface reflectance. So, if you do not have the third thing, you just select, you can just select the what is the thing. Okay. You can also select the log scale, semi log scale, all these things from here. Okay. Yeah, basically in case of you do not understand which curve is giving you. So, you can just go here and remove other two things. Okay, you go to none, you can understand what is the thing. Legends, I do not think it is given generally here. Huh? Yeah, whatever. Yeah. So, you can draw separately defined kind of graph. So, if you go here, you will find defined. You can define anything on this curve thing. No, the curve might shift on top of another. No? Here, reflectance is at bottom, so it is giving at the bottom. Yeah, you can just put on this ledge here and we will see the, it will show what kind of curve is it. It is.
Click on the curve and the bottom it shows.
Bottom it will show what curve it is. And it will also show the value actually. What is the data point? Okay, everybody is fine with the graph thing. Graph thing is fine. Okay, so the last thing is the batch, to make a batch simulation. So, if you go back here, here is an option for quick batch or batch. If you click it, it will open a window like this. So, here you can vary different parameters and give the range, and you can see, you can put the how many number of steps you want to put in this range, and you can see what the output, the change in the output due to the change of this parameter. Okay. So, first let us assume, let us change the background doping, okay, from say let us say 1 e to the power 15 to 1 e to the power 17 or 18. Okay. And let us say number of steps to be 20. So, we will change the background doping from 15 to 18 and we will see the effect on the output thing, like what are the output things, like base VOC. Here base VOC means the open circuit voltage only. So, base means here it is not basic kind of thing, it is the VOC of the cell. So, all the things are written here is in terms of base VOC, base ISC or base P max, like that. So, this is just the VOC thing. Okay. The next thing is the base ISC and base P max. So, we will change the background doping in this range and we will see the effect on the these three parameters. Now, if you click OK and run it, it will run, but it will not show the results. Actually, you have to click in this context. So, it is a common mistake. So, sometimes it does not show. Okay. So, you just select quick batch and you will see all the things, I mean listed out here. The background doping we have selected from 1 e to the power 15 to 1 e to the power 18 in 20 steps. So, there are 20 steps in which it has been selected. Okay. So, there are sometimes problem in this log scale, actually sometimes it jumps from in the initial values and in that it splits the other range in some level. Anyway, so now if you run it, you will see the all the values. Taking place. So, similarly, you can put other things too. So, you can go for multiple options and permute them, all these options. So, range varying from this to value to this, other base resistivity varies varying from other thing, and you can get all these details, I mean the effect of this variation out here. So, we will get. Now, if you have got these results and you want to copy it. So, if you just go to again the graph section, you will again copy, get the thing like copy batch data. So, you can just copy from here and put it in notepad file. So, all the things will be again, you can save in notepad file. Okay. So, I think this is a basic thing for PC 1D simulation. Now, again if you want to go back to the excitation kind of thing. So, I think we had selected QE thing. So, that is why it had given some bad results, I think. Actually, it was set as scan Q, that is why it was giving some bad results. So, this is the actual results for one sun excitation. Okay. So, that is all, I hope. And one last thing is that if you are not able to put any kind of values, you can just open a default file for a silicon solar cell like PV cell, and it will give the very basic cell saved in the PC1D software. So, it will give the all the values ready made for you. So, you can see for as it for reference. You just go to file option, open, and you will find all different type of devices loaded here. Yeah, this is bipolar junction transistor and diode. So, you can simulate all these things here out here. Okay. So, different type of device you can simulate out here. So, for that you have some kind of reference device.
Okay. So,
questions regarding simulation? So we have some time so that you can try your hands on the simulator yourself. So one more candidate is here to help you. So now you can actually go around and help them. So Karthik, Jim, Mehul and Som is here. So please run your own simulator, take all the possible parameters, draw the agenda, draw the quantum efficiency, save them, do the best simulation. Okay? And make a research paper. What is electrical equivalent circuit of the solar cell? So there is a diode, right? So PN junction powered by a diode. It has to be a diode. So what is the
So what do you think? What do you think is the electrical equivalent circuit of the solar cell? So what was the equation of solar cell? Right? This is the equation of solar cell. What does this represent? This represents diode. And this is light generated current. Okay, it's a current source. So you need to have a current source. Right? The current from the current source is in the opposite direction of the diode. Right? So diode has to be in the opposite direction. So diode has to be like this. That's it. With, of course, then you can put series resistance and shunt resistance. And here is your voltage. This is light dependent current, sir. It depends on the light. What is the? I don't think there is any symbol. You can create one. Diode with? That is, I think, with photodiode or something. I don't know. How to measure RS and RSH? You can do it looking at the IV curve of solar cell. Okay? From the IV curve, and there are various methods by for measuring series and shunt resistance of a solar cell. So measuring typical value for RS should be in milliohms, okay, 1 to 5 milliohms. It should be small, right? RS should really be small, and RSH, the shunt resistance, should really be large. So it will be 500 ohm, kilo ohms, that range. So shunt resistance should be very large. Ideally infinity, series resistance should be very low, ideally zero. If you connect many cells in series, RS should be added, right? It's just like you are adding, if one series resistance of cell is 1 milliohm, if you are putting 10 in series, it will become 10 milliohm of the combination. So I don't think the lecture on the modules is being planned in this 5 days, but when we discuss the module, we discuss what is the IV curve of the module in which we add series resistance, divide the shunt resistance, add the current, voltage, whatever, depending on the series and parallel combination of cells. So similar to this, we can also write the IV characteristic of a module. Of course, this the equation that you see on the top does not take care of the series resistance and shunt resistance. But you can also add within that series and shunt resistance, and you can have the modified IV equation of a solar cell.
So the voltage will be around 0.7 volt all the time.
Okay, just listen 1 minute. Just do one assignment. Without that, you will not get tea today. On your computer, make a solar cell which is exactly 10% efficient, not 9.5, not 10.5, 10% efficient, and show me the IV curve of the 10% efficient solar cell.
exactly 10, not 9.5, not 10.5. Okay, so you, what does it mean? You need to adjust the parameter such that you get a 10% efficient solar cell. Yeah, so don't write directly cell efficiency equal to 10%, except that you can adjust any parameter that you want. Okay, okay, do it. And as soon as you make a 10% efficient solar cell, you can leave for the team. Okay, one more thing. So the simulator will not give you the efficiency directly. So what you have to do is it gives a Pmax value. Okay, it gives a Pmax value, which is Vm times Im. Then you can actually calculate, and it also gives VOC and ISC. Okay, so you can calculate the fill factor. You can you know the VOC ISC, and then from the last expression, you can actually calculate the efficiency. Okay, so you do this. It gives this, so you know this, you know VOC, ISC, you know this from here, so you can calculate the fill factor. Once you know the fill factor, this is the expression for the efficiency, VOC, ISC, fill factor divided by Pin. Okay, what is Pin you have to take? 1000 watt per meter square. So make sure that you are using your cell area also appropriately, right? 1000 watt per meter square. And convert meter square into centimeter square, otherwise your efficiency will be some 1000 or something. Vm, the voltage at the maximum power point. Yeah, so this, just draw the Vm and Im. So the Vm is the voltage at the maximum power point, and Im is the current at the maximum power point. And from the VI curve, which also show the ISC and VOC. So from the VI curve, you know ISC and VOC value. Okay. And at the maximum power point, current at the maximum power point is Im, voltage at the maximum power point is Vm. Okay, so now you need to make a 10% efficient solar cell. Okay, if you have got the 10%, please help your neighbor. Please help your neighbor to get 10%. Yeah, Brijesh, go around and help people. 10.33, not acceptable. 10, it has to be 10. 9.96 is okay. Very close. So you can change any parameters. Okay, you have to make actually the default file gives what efficiency default file gives. So the default file gives you 13%. So you can actually make the cell worse. No, you do whatever you want. You reduce the lifetime, you reduce, you increase the reflectance, you increase the surface recombination velocity. So you can start with the default file, which gives you 13% efficiency. Go from 13% to 10% by changing the parameter, by making the worse parameter. If anybody got the 10%, please help your neighbors. Yeah. 10.4 is not acceptable. 10.04 is okay. Ninety-nine point four. 9.94 is okay. You still not got the 10?
Not, sir.
Okay. Where are you? What you got?
I got 10%. I am actually, is it practical to vary the junction depth also?
Yes, yes, it is practical. You can do that.
But that will not be practically
possible. I mean, you cannot make a 5 micron junction depth. You can make up to 1 micron.
The effect of junction depth is more than recombination.
Yes, yes. That's why people want to make it thinner and thinner. Going deeper is very difficult. You got it? Why? I mean, you can't make a bad cell. I mean, it's normally it is difficult to make a good cell, but I think bad was should be easy. What surface conventional velocity? No, least is better, right? You have to make take the worst. Yeah, so you have to take 1 million, 10^6. Then you will get less than 10% immediately. Yeah, so you take 1 microsecond or 0.1 microsecond. So to make the choice worse. So help others. Anybody who got it, help others, otherwise tea is getting cold. Got it? How much you are getting? Yeah, you have to be very close to 10. You can change it. One simple thing to change is reflectance. You reflect more light. Exactly 10%. Okay, wonderful. So now you can go for tea. 10.15 is still large difference. No? People make so much effort to just increase by 0.1%. Okay, so one simple way to reduce the efficiency is to increase the reflectance. Very simple. Other simple way to do it, decrease your lifetime, base lifetime. Third simple way is increase your surface recombination velocities to very high value. (11.29) still high. (10.7) No, it's big difference. 9.96 is okay. Okay, let us stop now because the next section will get delayed.